Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install MinGW Compiler in a distro operating system. And then I will also show you how to run a simple C++ program in a distro operating system. So let's begin. Now to install MinGW Compiler, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in the address bar you need to just simply type MinGW distro. Yeah, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this MinGW distro-nu-wen.net is basically our first search result. So now just simply click on MinGW distro, and this will now going to redirect you to this official site of MinGW distro. In here, if you just simply scroll down a bit, you'll be getting these two options. One is MinGW 17.1 exe and another is MinGW 17.1 without git.exe. Now, if you see, this file size is 87.2 MB and its file size is just 45.1 MB. So what I'll be suggesting you is to download this MinGW 17.1 without git.exe. So this will basically do, we don't want to use git now. So this will basically actually going to fulfill our need. So just, you know, simply click on MinGW 17.1 and you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly started downloading our MinGW. Since I have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this MinGW 17.1 without git has been rightly downloaded over here. So here what we need to do is, you need to just simply double click on it, and this will, you know, going to open this 7-zip location. So here you need to just simply minimize our download directory, and here you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly given a path. So we need to change this part to our C drive. So for that, you need to just simply click on this triple dot, and this will, you know, going to open this browse for folder window. In here, you need to just simply scroll down a bit and you'll be getting this local disk C. So just simply click on that and then just simply click on OK. So you are basically going to extract this MinGW at our C:\, that is basically the base file of our C drive. So just, you know, simply do that much and then just simply click on extract, and you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly started extracting our MinGW compiler. So this will, you know, going to take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing MinGW compiler. Yeah, so we'll come back, and now as you can clearly see, our MinGW compiler has been, you know, rightly extracted. So just, you know, simply click on this window and you need to just simply go to our local disk C. And here you can clearly see our MinGW compiler has been rightly extracted. So just, you know, simply go inside that folder and you can see all files has been rightly extracted, right? So now you need to just simply go inside this bin folder, and then you need to just simply click on this address bar, then right click on it and copy. Yeah. And then just simply minimize this window. And now you need to just simply click on this tool icon, basically the search icon. And here you need to just simply type environ, and you will be getting this edit the system environment variables. So just, you know, simply click on that, and this is, you know, going to open the system properties. In here, you need to just simply click on environment variables, and this is, you know, going to open this environment variables window. In here, you need to just simply click on path, then edit, and now you need to just simply click on new, then right click on it and paste. So we are basically going to extract our MinGW in our C drive, and then we are basically going to copy that bin file, basically that bin path location, and then we are basically going to paste that in our edit environment variables. Right, so you need to do this much only, and then just simply click on OK, then again OK, then again OK, right? And now if you just simply go to our command prompt, and here if you just simply type gcc space --version, then enter, you can clearly see our GCC version 9.2.0 has been rightly installed on our machine. So if you see this message, that is this GCC, then all this basically mean is your MinGW compiler has been rightly installed, right? So now if you just, you need to just simply close this command prompt and then right click on it and then new, then folder. So here what we are going to do is we are going to write a simple CPP program. So for that, let us first create a new folder. So that is this C program CPP, then just go inside that folder, then right click on it, new, and then text document. So just let me simply go inside that text document, and in here we are going to write a simple C++ program. So hash include iostream, then using namespace std, then create our main method, just end with our brace, and then to just simply print hello world. So cout angular bracket, then what we need to do is just simply end with endl, and we need to print hello world. We need to also end with semicolon, right? And we need to also return a zero, since we are making it as a int main, right? So now you need to just simply click on file, then save as, and then you need to just simply give a file name as prog.cpp. Remember, for C++, you need to save this file as .cpp extension, right? And then you need to just simply click on save as type, then all file type. That's a very important step. You need to save this file as all file type, and to give this extension as .cpp. Then just simply click on save. And you can clearly see our prog.cpp has been, you know, rightly saved over here, right? So if you just simply minimize it now, and you can clearly see this plus icon has been created. This might be different for you, that's not an issue. The thing is, you'll be getting this C++ source over here. So here you need to just simply click on this address bar, and then just simply type cmd, then enter, and you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly opened our command prompt with this cpp folder location, right? So here you need to just simply type g++, then space, and then the name of our file, that is prog.cpp, right? So prog.cpp, then enter, and you can clearly see, okay, so we have some typo. We forgot to give a double angular bracket, that is what we need to get, sorry. So now just, you know, simply save this file, and then just, you know, simply run that file once again, and now you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly executed with no error, right? So if you just simply minimize it, you can see a name has been created with A. So now if you just simply type A over here and then enter, you can clearly see this hello world has been, you know, rightly shown, right? So this A application will be created after successful compilation of your file. So this is basically our compilation step. G++ prog.cpp, that is the file name, and G++ is basically what we are doing is compiling our C++ program. So it has, you know, rightly created an output file. But this A is not an user friendly one, right? So what I'll be suggesting you is to, you know, just simply execute a dash O. This O basically means output. So G++ prog.cpp dash O. This dash O is basically a flag for output, right? And then you need to set a user friendly name. So let's set this name as output, then enter. And now you can clearly see a output file created with the name output itself, not A. So we have created a user friendly name, and now if you just simply type output over here and then enter, this will, you know, also going to print this hello world itself, right? So we are basically going to make it user friendly to, you know, generate our custom file name with for our output file, right? So in this way, you can easily install MinGW compiler in your distro operating system, and you can easily run any C++ program in your distro operating system. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.